Hello, dear students and parents. Welcome to the next episode of International Educationalist. ഇന്ന് ഇന്ത്യയിൽ നിന്ന് പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് കേരളത്തിൽ നിന്നും വിദേശ രാജ്യങ്ങളിലേക്ക് പഠിക്കുവാൻ പോകുന്ന വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം തേടി യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റികളിലേക്ക് പോകുന്ന സ്റ്റുഡൻസിൽ ഏറ്റവും കൂടുതൽ ഏത് കാറ്റഗറിയിൽ നിന്നാണ്, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഏത് തരം ഏത് സബ്ജക്റ്റിലേക്കാണ് ഈ വിദ്യാർത്ഥികൾ ഇന്ത്യ വിട്ട് മറ്റു രാജ്യങ്ങളിലേക്ക് പോകുന്നത്? തീർച്ചയായും അതിൻ്റെ ഉത്തരം നിങ്ങൾക്ക് തന്നെ അറിയാം. അത് MBBS എന്ന ഒറ്റ പ്രോഗ്രാമാണ്. മെഡിസിൻ പഠിക്കാൻ വിദേശത്ത് പോകുന്ന വിദ്യാർത്ഥികൾ അവരുടെ യഥാർത്ഥ ലക്ഷ്യം എന്താണ്? MBBS ഗ്രാജുവേറ്റായി ഇന്ത്യയിലേക്ക് തിരിച്ചു വരിക എന്നുള്ള ഒരു ലക്ഷ്യത്തോടുകൂടിയാണോ യഥാർത്ഥത്തിൽ ഈ MBBS എന്ന സ്വപ്നം ഒരു കുട്ടിയും അവരുടെ രക്ഷിതാവും ആരംഭിക്കുന്നത്? മെഡിക്കൽ വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം MBBSൽ ഒതുങ്ങുന്നതാണോ? MBBS എന്ന ഒറ്റ ഡിഗ്രി കൊണ്ട് നിങ്ങൾ ഡോക്ടറായി മാറുന്നുണ്ടോ? ഇല്ല എന്നുള്ളതാണ് വാസ്തവം. അങ്ങനെയുള്ള അൺസർട്ടനിറ്റീസ് നിലനിൽക്കെ വിദേശത്ത് മെഡിക്കൽ വിദ്യാഭ്യാസത്തിന് പോകുന്ന ഒരു വിദ്യാർത്ഥിക്ക് അവിടെ തന്നെ സ്പെഷ്യലൈസ് ചെയ്യാൻ പോസിബിലിറ്റി നൽകുന്ന രാജ്യങ്ങൾ ഉണ്ടോ? അങ്ങനെയുള്ള രാജ്യങ്ങളിൽ സ്പെഷ്യലൈസേഷൻ പോസിബിലിറ്റീസ് നൽകുന്ന യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റികളുണ്ടോ? ഉണ്ട്. അങ്ങനെയുള്ള ഒരു യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റിയെക്കുറിച്ചാണ്, അങ്ങനെയുള്ള ഡെസ്റ്റിനേഷനെക്കുറിച്ചാണ് എനിക്ക് നിങ്ങളോട് ഇന്ന് സംസാരിക്കുവാനുള്ളത്. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് നത്തിങ് എൽസ് ദാൻ പോളണ്ട്. വൺസ് അഗെയിൻ, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് നത്തിങ് എൽസ് ദാൻ കൊളഗിയം മെഡിക്കൽ നിക്കോളസ് കോപ്പർനിക്കസ് യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി ഇൻ ദ സിറ്റി ഓഫ് ബിഡിഗോസ്. ഈ യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റിയുടെ ഏറ്റവും വലിയ പ്രത്യേകത എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് സെൻട്രൽ യൂറോപ്യൻ സിലബസ് ഫോളോ ചെയ്യുന്ന യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി. നേരത്തെ ഉള്ളൊരു എപ്പിസോഡിൽ ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞതുപോലെ ഷെങ്കൻ വിസ പോസിബിലിറ്റിയുള്ള പോളണ്ട് എന്ന രാജ്യത്തിൽ സെൻട്രൽ യൂറോപ്യൻ സിലബസ് ഫോളോ ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരു യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി. എന്താണ് സെൻട്രൽ യൂറോപ്യൻ സിലബസിൻ്റെ പ്രത്യേകത? ഇൻ്റഗ്രേറ്റഡ് മാസ്റ്റർ ഡിഗ്രി എന്നൊരു പ്രോഗ്രാം. ദാറ്റ് മീൻസ് യു ലേൺ ഡിഗ്രി ആൻഡ് മാസ്റ്റർ ഡിഗ്രി ടുഗദർ, വേർ യു ഹാവ് എ പോസിബിലിറ്റി ഓഫ് സ്പെഷ്യലൈസേഷൻ ഇൻ ദ ഡിസൈഡ് സ്ട്രീം. നിങ്ങൾ ഒരു സ്പെഷ്യലിസ്റ്റ് ആകാൻ ആഗ്രഹിക്കുന്ന അതേ സ്ട്രീമിൽ, അതേ സബ്ജക്റ്റിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് സ്പെഷ്യലൈസ് ചെയ്യാൻ, റെസിഡൻഷ്യൽ പ്രാക്ടീസ് ചെയ്യാൻ ഓപ്പർച്യൂണിറ്റി ഒരുക്കുന്ന ഒരു യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി. ഐ വെൽക്കം പ്രൊഫസർ ആൻഡ് ഡോക്ടർ ആർക്കേഡിയസ് യാവിയൻ, ദ ഡയറക്ടർ ഓഫ് സെൻറ്റർ ഫോർ മെഡിസിൻ എഡ്യൂക്കേഷൻ ഇൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ്, കൊളഗിയം മെഡിക്കൽ നിക്കോളാസ് കോപ്പർനിക്കസ് യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി, ടു ദിസ് ടോക്ക് ഷോ വിത്ത് ഇന്റർനാഷണൽ എഡ്യൂക്കേഷനലിസ്റ്റ്.
First of all, I welcome you to the talk show of International Educationalist. This is a platform where the students and the parents can get to know about your university, the medical education, the program, the curriculum, everything. I really think that this will be very helpful for the students across the globe.
Thank you very much for your kind invitation. It is my pleasure to be in this project, and as probably you know, and maybe majority of the people, that we have already some ties, and we have already some students which were recruited by your company and who are studying and attending classes in our medical school here.
As I am already experienced the Bidigost and the Torun, I understand that what is Bidigost, and very happy. This is one of the happiest places for me, which recalls me. Yeah, I need to go back again to the city. I need to see, watch the city. I need to be in the city. I need to visit the campus. I need to visit this, meet these people. Still, the students will have the curiosity to know about the city of Bidigost and Torun, where the medical university is located. Could you please explain about the cities?
Yeah, we have to go a little bit into the history. Here in Bydgoszcz, which is the eighth biggest city in Poland with almost 400,000 inhabitants, very early in the 20th century, there was a medical academy, because at that time that was the name of the medical schools and medical education. Then in year 2004, the big University of Nicolaus Copernicus in Torun, which is the city of around 200,000 inhabitants, 40 kilometers south from Bydgoszcz, asked us if we want to join the Nicolaus Copernicus University. And General Will was positive, and that's why from year 2004, so since 2004, we are the part of the University of Nicolaus Copernicus. We maintain the name Collegium Medicum, which is named by Ludwig Rüdiger, who was a professor of surgery. And he was, in fact, the first person ever who developed the gastric resection in the year 1881 in a small place close to our city. It's called Chełmno. And that procedure was then performed for next almost 120 years. So that person was very well known. So that's why the Collegium Medicum is now wearing the name of Ludwig Rüdiger. All I have to say here that all medical education is performed here in our city. So that means if the students come to the Nicolaus Copernicus University in Torun, in fact, they are studying in Collegium Medicum, which is located in Bydgoszcz. Our campus is well organized and is situated almost in the center of the city. And the additional buildings or additional locations, like for example, hospitals, are not so far away from the main center, also from the main students' dormitory. So altogether, the distance to attend the classes, to attend the lectures is very close and is very comfortable. Also, the commuting in our city is easy because we have a very nice network of trams as well as buses. So it's really easy to get to the places where the students stay or where the students get the education.
Wow. I got a very brief explanation about the university. It's a good briefing that you briefed about the city as well as about the possibilities of students in the university, that about the dormitory, the location, everything. That sounds very interesting. As same as you talked about the city, and as I am personally also interested about Poland, there are a lot of facts which keeps us interesting about Poland. At the same time, I know that the curriculum followed by the CMNCU, the Collegium Medicum Nicolaus Copernicus University, is something unique when we compare with the countries like Russia, Ukraine, Georgia, like that, because these are the so-called medical destinations, especially for Indian students or Asian students. And unlike this curriculum, the CMNCU may be as the path of Central European curriculum. It follows the integrated master degree in medicine. So it's very interesting, and I personally understand that it's much advantageous for the students. So we would like to listen about the curriculum from you.
What I can say about this is that you have to remember that Poland is a part of the European community. So that is a huge advantage, because everything what we acquired from so-called Western Europe, this is also a sort of education. So within the last 20 years, we changed quite a lot in our education. And now the education is comparable to the countries like Germany, France, UK, and so on. What that really means, that the level of education is becoming very high. And in plus, or in advantage of this, is that our diploma is recognized in the European community. What that really means for the normal students, and especially for the graduates, that for them, if they decide to work in different countries, all they have to do is just to learn a local language, because this is something what they need to know to become and practice medicine. But the diploma is immediately valid in the European community. If they want to go to UK or USA, obviously they have to pass additional exams, but obviously having that sort of education on the high level here in our institution, obviously it's easier to pass the exam. So if we speak about the syllabus, the studies, contains 6 years. The first 2 years are theoretical, containing the classes in anatomy, physiology, pathophysiology, biochemistry. And then from the year third, it starts a sort of clinical approach for the diseases or for the fields like, let's say, internal medicine, surgery, pediatrics, gynecology, and obstetrics, and so on. And you have to remember that it goes gradually, year by year. So acquiring first the theoretical knowledge, then you can use that knowledge in the clinical years. And the clinical years are organized in such a thing that you have at the beginning a sort of examination of the patients, and then later, the not only the diagnostic, but making diagnosis, and finally having an access also into the operating rooms or to the places where you can be trained practically. So altogether, I think, fulfills all the requirements. In addition, something what is very particular here in our medical school is fantastic simulation center. Nowadays, a good medical school cannot perform all these classes without a simulation. And we have a well-organized simulation center where all students go and practice from the beginning up to the very sophisticated stuff. When, for example, you have a simulation in ICU, which is the intensive care unit, when the students are performing everything from reanimation up to the treatment. And obviously they are checked not only by the computers, but also by the highly motivated and highly experienced medical staff.
Okay. This is also very much interesting that the curriculum give the experience of real medical education along with the practical exposure to the students. And this 6 years of integrated master degree in medicine allow the students to continue their residential practice there in Europe, I think.
Yes. That is what, yes, that's completely right. The 6 year of our medical school is a very practical one. So the students goes from one to another department, one to another clinic. And then obviously they have also a special time for the fields which they can choose. So that gives them at least a first beginning into the future specialization. So graduating from the medical school, the students have, I think, all possibility, not only to know all the fields, but also getting a sort of taste of specialization they want to do in the future.
Yeah, after the 6 years of education, along with the core subject selected in the sixth year, along with the curriculum, they can go ahead with the to work as an assistant doctor in the area of residential practice in a particular hospital, any of the hospitals in Poland or in other European Union countries.
Obviously, that's very easy right now, especially for the Polish students, because they know Polish and they are fluent in this language. So for them, it's very easy to graduate from the medical school. Still, there is still a huge lack of doctors in my country. So there is no problem to find a place to work, and sometimes a very interesting place. There is also no problem to do the specialization in different fields. So all we only need a very motivated graduates from our medical school who knows exactly what they want to do. For the foreigners, obviously, if they want to stay in Poland, that's possible, but they have to know Polish. They have to pass additional language of the examination of the language, and then they can find the job. If they want to go to the other countries, the requirements are very similar. So that means that our diploma is valid. All they need in addition is an examination in local language. If they pass that, obviously the doors are open, and I think they can practice as a doctors, first from internship, then residency program, and finally as a consultant and so on.
This is something like the Central European syllabus. It's beautiful, and it gives a lot of opportunity for the students. The real motivated students, they can start practicing as a consultant specialist sooner in the future.
As I mentioned already, everything depends on the personality of the people who are studying medicine, of they internal interest, what they really want to do, because medicine, like not other fields, is giving a wide range of different possibilities to practice. If they want to be, let's say, scientists, they can be the scientists. If they want to do some research in the basic or in the theoretical fields, they can do. If they want to do the clinical research, they can do. If they want to only practice medicine, they can also do in different fields. So medicines, it is a sort of wide range of opportunities.
Yeah. So this is totally a superb opportunity for the foreign students, especially when it comes to the medical education in Collegium Medicum Nicolaus Copernicus University. Even though the university is huge in its size, it has a huge capacity to conceive a lot of students. I find that the university in its English division will accept only 96 students. This is something like something, again, unique, I say, because I know many of the universities in Eastern European countries, they accept even 100, 150 or 200 or 300 students from my country alone. Still, CMNCU is very particular. Yeah, we need only 96 students. And these 96 students will be accepted only through an online test, which is followed by a Skype session. I would like to know why such kind of a very strict screening system is implemented.
Okay, we implemented that, as you just mentioned, a very strict recruitment of our students, because what matters in our Collegium Medicum is a quality, not the quantity, but quality. And if you want to select a good students, we have to get to know them. And what we see from the first part, it is obviously the achievement in a local schools, okay? Then obviously there is an interview, and the interview is in fact a sort of important part of the recruitment of our future students, because we can assess first the language they used to talk, the knowledge of the medical terms, the knowledge of the basic science, then obviously, what matters a lot, and motivation. Why they want to be a medical doctors? In current world, this is not as obvious as we can think that everybody wants to be a medical doctor. As you know, the MD means also $1 million. And if somebody thinks about that this is $1 million that they can get after becoming a medical doctor, then obviously it will be difficult to get to our medical school. Because what counts here is a sort of involvement in the treatment of the patient, a passion, something what is in the heart, which allowed them to treat patients in the proper way. So if we can find such a candidate, then obviously we widely accept them to our medical school. And as I mentioned, the quality of the person, a quality of personality of the candidates is a really important part. So we do not even think about expanding the number of students for the English division. So that means 96 students per year. This is the maximal number we are going to accept every year. That gives you, I'm talking about the students, the future students, it will give you much friendly, you know, relation among yourself, but also much more friendly relation with teachers, with the doctors in the hospital later on, when you will be in the clinical years. And also, I think, much more personal approach to the patients as well as to studying medicine. So that's what really matters in our Collegium Medicum.
That's really, really true. What you said is that the student's personality, the motivation really matter. That's true. And the individual attention given to the student. That once I started to learn about this university, I found that the students professor ratio is 12:1. But now I find it's something like 6:1. The group is again into the smaller numbers. So it also gives additional advantage.
That's totally right. We are trying to manage to have a smaller groups. We'll see, because as you can imagine, we should improve our facilities just to have that sort of relation and decreasing the number of students in the group. We are in the process of expanding our hospitals, our educational facilities. It will happen probably within the next 2-3 years. And then, you know, if I will be still, you know, managing English division in this university, maybe I will be happy to tell you or welcome our condition improved. And now you can even get a better education than that what we are providing you right now.
Yeah, coming to the point of the hospitals, there are already 9 hospitals, including the medical hospitals, medical colleges, 2 medical colleges of the university. So there are already 9 hospitals. We would like to know how it becomes much beneficial for the students to practice.
You know, in our country and in our medical school, it is very obvious that all the education in medicine is based on the personal contact with the patients. Obviously, I can understand that you not speaking Polish will have a little bit limited access, but you have to remember that we as a teachers, we can be also a translator. We will be teach you how to use different maneuvers to examine the patient. We will teach you how to talk to the patients, you know, how to get the information from the patients. And obviously, for those who will be very motivated, they will be very eager, you know, to work that way, it will get all the necessary information. We are here in Bydgoszcz in a very privileged situation because we have really 9 hospitals, different places. So I think you will accept going from one hospital to another to see different approaches, because even if everything right now in medicine is based on something what is called evidence-based medicine, when we want to treat the patients, obviously there are local policies how to treat the patients, how to use the drugs, what procedure perform, what procedure will be better for what patients, and so on. So there is several different questions, and you will get the answer for that, and then at the end everything will be depending on you, on the level of your education and your final decision how to make a good treatment for your personal patient.
Of course, we have no doubt about the practical exposure given by the CMNCU and the medical facilities given by its hospital. I have seen in the records that the hospital number 2 of in Bydgoszcz, it was listed in 2014 in the Forbes magazine as the world's best medical facilitated hospital.
Okay, if we speak about all these rankings, I have to say that obviously they are very subjective. We are very happy to be in the top rank because that gives us a sort of impression that we perform everything in a nice way. But I have to say that probably in my city, the best hospital, the best organized and having the best facilities is the oncological hospital. University hospital number 2 and my university hospital number 1, they're also very high in the ranking list. But you have to remember that oncology, it is a very specific field, not only in my country, but everywhere in the world, they have as additional financial support. So that's why in majority of the countries, oncological hospitals are better equipped and they have a better facilities. We as a university hospitals, when we admit almost all patients, and there is no in our country, in our university hospital number 1 and university hospital number 2, where we are admitting all patients, doesn't matter what sort of disease, then obviously the amount of the patient coming is very high. That obviously gives you as a student possibility to see the wide range of the different diseases, different patients, and obviously different procedures. But obviously for such a hospitals, it's very difficult to get a very high position on the list. Those hospitals which are the specialized hospitals, they are usually getting much higher position than we as a general hospital, having different fields and managing day by day with the emergency patients.
Okay, and we talk about the ranking of the university in different streams. I can see it is showcased in World's Best that if I go through the list of ranking of the medical universities, particularly, this is in the first 600 across the globe. And when we go to the anatomy alone, it is nation number one. It's number one in Poland, the anatomy department. So there is no doubt that the university is giving the students with the best academic as well as the practical possibilities. And you already told about the possibility of the students to practice post-education in the European Union. So at the same time, I would like to know more about the possibilities after studying, after completing this education, the possibility of practicing in UK as well as USA. Why? Because the English-speaking countries are always an attraction for the medical graduates.
Yeah, we have already, you know, the Indian students. We have also students from Ireland, from UK, after graduating from our medical school. When they apply, you know, to the institutions in UK, where they can pass ECFMG examination over there. And then obviously, if they pass positively this, they can go and practice this in UK or Ireland. So, as I mentioned before, everything depends on the student itself. If they are good, if it's motivated, if he or she wants to get, you know, to the certain field or to the certain country and work there, our education, which we provide to the students, is really enough to pass the exam first, and then in addition to work in the other countries. I understand that Indian students, Indian people knowing English probably on very good level, as we see here, for them, obviously the market for working will be Ireland, UK, Australia, USA, and so on. So that means in general countries where the English is a mother tongue. So for you, remember, you have to, in the USA, you have to pass the US MLE. And obviously during studying medicine here in our institution, we can tell you how to prepare for this US MLE examination. If UK, this is ECFMG, and then you can directly contact the offices in London, in UK, and then you can get full information. And in the other countries, as I said, this is on your side. If you want, it's up to you.
Yeah, as you said, the European Union, the entire European Union countries are open for the students to complete the education in Collegium Medicum Nicolaus Copernicus University. Especially the countries like Poland and Germany are already in deficiency of doctors, I think. I have seen the data like that.
Yeah. I can only what you just said, because that's true. Since there is no borders in European community, the people can freely go from country to country. The normal people who are not medical doctors, if they require certain medical treatment, they can get that within the EU. And I think that suddenly they realize that the quality of care getting in another country, if very similar to that what we have in Poland, and sometimes in Poland is even better than that, what give them in the other countries, and vice versa. I don't want to say that there is a huge differences. As I said, the biggest advantage of EU right now is that the standard of living is starting to become a very equal in all the countries, and the medical care seems to be very comparable, which gives us, you know, a sort of feeling of safety if you go somewhere, not only for working, but also for getting, you know, the help.
That's a very valid point that the European Union countries now are having a uniform standard of living. That I have traveled to Germany, I can see the same living standard in Poland, the facilities in Poland. But the very interesting fact is that the cost of living for an international student, it's much lesser than in Germany. The Poland is much economical.
Yeah, obviously I'm talking about the equal standard of living, but you have to remember that our starting point was different than German starting point. So obviously certain things are much more expensive in Germany than in Poland. And we still have, you know, certain work to do to become even richer and better developed. But anyway, that's true that for students and also for us, for citizens, standard of living is quite high in Poland for much lower price that you have to pay in the other European countries. So that gives us a sort of possibility, you know, to spend less money. But on the other hand, we have to remember that our salaries for our work.
Yeah, and we have, I think, almost everything is covered. Country that is a independent country and an independent country from 1990, I think. But yes, the way the 1989. So, but the country has a very, very fast development.
Yeah.
It is the fifth largest economy in European Union.
That's completely right. But that you have to remember, for years we were struggling to get an independence. And when we get the independence in 1989, in fact, then suddenly, you know, the Polish were inspired to do everything to become, you know, a country comparable to that what was in the west of Europe. And this sort of motivation is still very, very vivid in our nation. So that's why we are really working very hard. We are trying to get as fast as possible to the level of the rich countries. And I think we are doing quite well. Our economy, as you just mentioned, is doing quite well, although the crisis right now is everywhere and we'll see what the future years will bring us. But we are very positive about that, what we are doing, because we know that we are hardworking, that we care about the other people, and we want to get to the level of the rich countries. So, as I said, we are a really motivated nation, and I think we have a very strong spirit of freedom and independence, and this is a sort of engine for us to work hard, you know, and perform on a way like the other countries cannot do it.
Apart from all these things, Poland is providing the international students with a one-year post-study visa, something like a stay back. They can stay back, they can prepare themselves for the next level. That is very interesting. Let's welcome the international students together. Let's welcome them together to the Collegium Medicum Nicolaus Copernicus University. I'm very thankful for the session. I'm very thankful for the time. But I know that you are one among the busiest persons that I have ever met in my life. I understand it truly, but I'm very happy that you spent around 30 minutes with me. Thank you very much, sir.
Once again, I want to thank you very much. I want to say that probably I am not the busiest man here in Poland, not hardworking as the others, but I am trying to do my best. But I want to say the last few words to future students and for the applicants or candidates to our medical school. If you want to get a good medical education, if you want to get to know my country, if you want to see how we do and how we are teaching future doctors, please come to Bydgoszcz, to Collegium Medicum of Nicolaus Copernicus University. And I think you should be happy because we have already 8 years of graduates of our medical school. The majority of them are really very satisfied with the knowledge they get from our medical school. And in addition, I have to say that their majority of them are doing very well. So they are having a good positions, they're working as a doctors, and they are happy even to contact us and telling us about their success. So I hope that the future for you in our city is a bright one. The only thing is just to pass the exam, just to get a good interview with us, and then come to Bydgoszcz to our Collegium Medicum. So welcome, we are waiting for you.
I thank my dear and beloved professor for his valuable time and this wonderful and informative session. Dear students and parents, ഇത് വളരെ ഇൻഫോർമേറ്റീവായിട്ടുള്ള സെഷൻ ആയിരുന്നു അല്ലേ? പ്രൊഫസർ ആർക്കഡിയസ് യാവിയൻ ഈസ് ദ ഫോർമർ പ്രസിഡന്റ് ഓഫ് Cardiovascular Surgery Society of European Union and for Poland. നമ്മൾ ഇന്ന് കേട്ട ഈ പോസിബിലിറ്റി, മെഡിക്കൽ എഡ്യൂക്കേഷനിലെ ഈ പോസിബിലിറ്റി നമ്മളുടെ ഇന്ത്യൻ വിദ്യാർത്ഥികൾക്ക് അവരുടെ സ്പെഷ്യലൈസേഷൻ, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ എനിക്ക് കാർഡിയോളജിസ്റ്റ് ആവണം, എനിക്ക് ഗൈനക്കോളജിസ്റ്റ് ആവണം, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ എനിക്ക് ന്യൂറോളജിസ്റ്റ് ആവണം എന്ന സ്വപ്നം സാക്ഷാത്കരിക്കാൻ ഓരോ ഇന്ത്യൻ വിദ്യാർത്ഥിയെയും സഹായിക്കാൻ, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അതിന് ഉതകുന്ന ഒരു പ്രോഗ്രാമാണ്. ടു നോ മോർ അബൌട്ട് ദിസ് യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി, ടു നോ മോർ അബൌട്ട് ദിസ് പ്രോഗ്രാം, പ്ലീസ് വിസിറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഫോളോ അവർ സോഷ്യൽ മീഡിയ പേജസ് ഫേസ്ബുക്ക് ആൻഡ് ഇൻസ്റ്റഗ്രാം. കീപ് വാച്ചിങ് മീ ആൻഡ് സ്റ്റേ ട്യൂൺഡ് ഇൻ ദ യൂട്യൂബ് ചാനൽ ഓഫ് ഇന്റർനാഷണൽ എഡ്യൂക്കേഷനലിസ്റ്റ് ഫോർ ദ നെക്സ്റ്റ് എപ്പിസോഡ്സ്. താങ്ക് യു വെരി മച്ച്.